fingers and then yank it out.
Oh! I can't.
Don't even think about it. It's like removing a splinter.
There is a hell of a lot more blood here than a splinter.
Don't show me that.
Maybe I can see clear inside your shoulder.
Close your eyes. I said close them. Now feel for the bullet, okay? And pinch it hard between the fingers. And once you got it, yank it out.
Jesus, that was disgusting. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Clyde, I figured we'd be halfway across the country by now.
Well, we're out of West Dallas, and
Clyde,
I think that's good enough.
I want to stop running.
We just gotta lay low.
I'm sick of running. I'm sick of the car and driving. I want to settle down.
You settle down, and I'm dead.
So this is it. This is our life.
Oh, what'd you think it was gonna be like, sugar?
I should have left you when I had the chance.
We'll find some place. We can stay for a while. They're looking for us in Kansas. We are fine so long as we stay here in Oklahoma. Okay, will you listen to me? We'll find an apartment, you know, something nice. Will you read to me or something? You know, I love it when you read to me.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on now.
You've heard them all, and the one I'm working on now ain't done.
Read me what you got. Read
me anything. I
don't care. Read it, damn it.
Okay. But I ain't done yet.
Understand.
You've read the story of Jesse James, of how he lived and died. If you're still in need of something to read, here's the story of Bonnie and Clyde. Nothing rhymes with Clyde and Bonnie.
Well, what about? You just go ahead.
Bonnie and Clyde are the Barrel Gang. I'm sure you all have read how they rob and steal, and those who squeal are usually found dying or dead.
Like that damn bank teller. Bam, bam, bam.
There's lots of untruths to these write-ups. They're not as ruthless as that. Their nature is raw. They hate all the law. The stool pigeons, spotters, and rats.
I'll tell you what. You sure have got the lingo, baby. You have got the lingo. And that is good. You send that to the papers, and I'll bet you they'll print it.
Really? You really think they'd print it?
They'll print anything that's got to do with us.
Oh, my God. I'm going to be published.
They call them cold-blooded killers, and they say they are heartless and mean. But I say it's for pride
that I once knew Clyde when he was honest, upright, and clean.
Governor Ferguson, what brings you here?
She has killed 4 people, and they're printing her poetry like she is some Emily frickin' Dickinson. We look like fools. I got a warden who can't keep criminals locked up, and a sheriff who can't catch them when they escape.
Now, Governor, in all fairness.
Fairness? 2 police officers and 2 civilians are dead. And public opinion is Bonnie and Clyde are heroes. There is no fairness, Sheriff.
Now I swear to you, we are on their trail, Governor.
Oh, I've read the reports. You have no idea where the hell they are.
I mean, you can see what I'm working with here. I got no money, no resources. I got 3 deputies sharing 2 shotguns, for Christ's sakes.
We almost had him at a roadblock, but the guy drives like the devil. Before you know it, he's crossed state lines, and there ain't nothing we can do.
That's because Clyde steals the fastest cars on the road. Well, y'all drive the heaviest cars built. Your police cars aren't built for speed, Sheriff. They're built for back roads, which is why even if you caught him, you couldn't catch him.
And who the hell are you?
Frank Hamer.
I contacted retired Texas Ranger Captain Frank Hamer and convinced him to accept a commission.
A commission to do what?
To hunt down Bonnie and Clyde, gentlemen.
True Detective says the cops are looking for us in Louisiana and Missouri. Oh, and get this. Escaped with Bonnie Parker, the ravishing redhead.
Well, that is you, Suge.
I wish they had a picture to go alongside this.
We don't want pictures. This job is hard enough. Pictures is the last thing we need.
Well, it just seems a shame not to have a nice big picture to go alongside where it says ravishing redhead. Oh, or the cover. Oh, baby, I want my picture on the cover. Who do we got to hold up to get my picture on the cover?
Now, you don't need no picture, baby. When someone sees your face, there ain't no way they're ever gonna forget it.
Oh, well, you're just partial.
Hell, I am. Yeah, I start thinking about my Bonnie.
Wait a minute, you wrote a song for me?
From the minute I wake up.
Oh, baby, you are so in love.
And that feeling is the best I'd ever had.
Wow, ravishing and a song. Well, this is just a fine day.
She is in my shaving mirror. She is in my coffee cup. I must be in love or else I'm going mad.
Well, this is just the finest thing.
Are you going to keep interrupting me?
I'm sorry.
I can't sing if you're going to do
Maybe
that. I got a rhythm, a flow going on.
Hey, my lips are sealed.
Okay. I would like to write to Bonnie, tell the girl the way I feel. But I'm better with a car than with a pen. It used to be I'm only happy when I'm set behind the wheel. Now I don't care if I ever drive again. Cause that girl's got some. Nothing scares her, only piece of luck that's ever come my way. I can't wait to tell her how much I've missed her. I'm feeling sorry for James Cagney, cause he's near. From the minute I'm asleep, they're the kind of dreams that keep you in your bed. Now I'm making love to Bonnie, and then your beats counting sheep. I got a feeling there are good times. Oh, something.
No.
Cut the lights. Oh, but you came!
Oh, God.
And did anybody follow you?
No, I swear.
Are you sure?
Buck,
I swear.
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Well, just Blanche.
Where's your horse?
They're fashionable. And they're comfortable in the car.
Son of a bitch, you came.
Your brother came to talk you into coming back to turn yourself in.
I turned myself in, Blanche, and I get the chair. And as happy as that would make you, well, I think I'm gonna pass. Come on.
Hey, Buck, did you see True Detective? They called me a ravishing redhead.
Oh, damn.
Redhead, please. Oh, that was not a judgment, Lord. Just a professional opinion.
money? My God, Mama! Oh my God! My baby! Are you all right?
I'm okay, Mama.
God, my precious baby.
Evening, Miss Park.
Mama, you remember Clyde?
Sure has been a while. Bonnie does nothing but talk about you, how much she loves you and how much she misses you. And I told her she could come by and see you anytime she wants. We can always find a way. We will always find a way. I want you to know I'm going to take good care of Bonnie, okay? I love her more than anything in this world. Yes, and, well, I know how hard times is, and I just want to help in any way I can. Well, there's $50 there, and you can do with it as you like, you know. Yes, well, I'll give you two some privacy.
I know how hard this must be for you, Mama, but I swear Clyde is a good man.
No, listen to me, honey.
He loves me.
Bonnie.
No, like a poet, he loves me.
Bonnie. I'm okay. I've just missed you so much.
Listen to me, Bonnie. Okay, Ted says you will only get a prison sentence if you come
Mama.
In and...